So starting with the cards that earn points is the MX Gold, the Green, the Platinum, the Preferred, Everyday, and Blue. Each card earns a certain amount of points on specific categories of purchases with different multipliers. Some have an annual fee and some don't. Now, the cards with an annual fee offer much better point earnings. I won't go into each card in this video because that would just take too long, but I'll show you how they earn points, and then you can look these cards up and decide which categories best fit your needs. I want to focus more on the point system here, so let's use the popular Gold card for example. This card will cost you $250 for an annual fee. Now, applying for this card right now gives you a welcome offer of 60,000 points if you spend $4,000 in the first 6 months. Now, usually that's about 35 or 40,000 points if you have a certain amount of spend in the first 3 months. So this is a really good offer. Each card has a different offer and they change frequently, so you want to look out for good offers. Also, ask for referral links from friends that might have an Amex card, because sometimes that will give you a better offer as well. The value of each point varies based on what you cash it in for. That's what we're going to look at here today, how to search for the best return in value. But for easy reference, we'll give each point a 2 cent value. You can get a better value, you can get a worse value, more or less than 2 cents per point. Travel redemptions range from around 1.7 cents per point to 2.3 cents per point. So we'll stick with the 2 cents per point for easy math. Now, travel redemption will often result in the best return for value for your points. You can get gift cards, you can get, you can credit your account with cash back, you can pay with your purchases using your points, you can buy products, things like iPhones, there's a ton of options available. But to really maximize the value of having an American Express card, you should stick with redeeming your points for travel. Now, with that welcome offer of 60,000 points, at 2 cents per point, that's $1,200. Now deduct the $250 that you'll spend on the annual fee, and you're still up $950. But the value can actually be far greater than that if the card is used correctly. Now, the Gold card offers 4 times points on supermarkets and restaurants. Remember, the average household cost for food in America is $7,923. If you use this card on all meals and groceries, that would be 7,923 points times 4 at 31,692 points. Just for buying something that you have to buy anyway. So remember, at 2 cents per point, that's $633 like we mentioned earlier. So now you've earned that $1,200 minus the $250 annual fee, you're up $950 plus $633 for food, and now you're at $1,583 after the first year. Let me say one more thing about the value of these points real quick. If you spend $100 at a supermarket and you get that 4x points, you get that 400 points at 2 cents per point, that's $8, which is 8% of the $100 that you just spent. So that's why I consider this card to be the best card for buying food. That, along with a ton of other credits that you'll get, and we'll go over that in a second, but 8% is really good. Now, you also get 3x points on airfare with flights booked directly with the airline or on AmexTravel.com. The average household spends